Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair Live. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you having a Kia Sportage, Kia Sorento guys, and you want to know what are the symptoms of bad crankshaft position sensor. Stay with us guys, we'll explain the most common symptoms. Before we start, let me tell you, it should work on most generation Kia Sportage, Kia Sorento. You don't need to remove your engine guys to replace crankshaft position sensor, but we have it out due to the fact that we'll be making hundreds of videos that can potentially save you thousands of dollars, and with the engine being out, we can clearly guys show you how to do that. So let's explain all about those symptoms. So as we said, that should work on most generation Kia Sportage, Kia Sorento guys. Before we start, let me tell you, every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos guys. We take them completely apart and we show you how to fix pretty much anything. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please guys, subscribe to the channel and like the video. Now, if you guys need to buy any parts or tools for a really good price and quick shipping as well, check out the link in the description of the video below and you can see where we get all our tools and parts from. So with that being said, let's explain how we're going to do that now. So that's the engine guys right here that we'll be demonstrating on. It's a 2.4 GDI engine, which is a very popular engine. They started using it in 2011 12 and even 10, I think even earlier, 10 models, and it goes all the way to 16 17. Then it's the revised version of that engine, which is very similar as well. Many of you guys have been asking us in the comment section below to share a link to a good diagnostic tool that we use. That's the one that we use daily guys. I'll put the link in the description of the video below if you need to check the current price and the functions, but it works on almost any car you can think of. Key is right here and it's an old system scanner. So the systems have crankshaft position sensor guys. Okay, bad crankshaft position sensor. If we come on the back side of that engine guys, on the very back, okay, right here you can see where that hole is. That's where usually the crankshaft position sensor is located, okay, in this hole right there. We have it removed, okay, and we have a special video that will explain how to test crankshaft position sensor guys on Kia on our YouTube channel World Mechanics. Check it out. Now that crankshaft sensor, what it does, it detects the exact position of the crankshaft. For instance, okay, if you look at the pulley here, that's a T, that's for a TDC, top dead center. Right here the mark, so you can see it's past top dead center. It needs to know exactly where that crankshaft is located, okay, all the time. The engine computer needs that information so it can synchronize the fuel injection system. It can synchronize when to ignite the fuel, variable timing, because it has a dual variable timing as well. So without that guys, okay, things will not work out. So if the sensor is bad, what you can experience, engine light on and having codes related to crankshaft position sensor, anything from P0335 to code P0339. Another thing guys, you may experience, okay, having hard time starting your Kia vehicle. It may take a long time to crank, and once it starts, it may not even perform correctly and may have no power at all. Number three, okay, sometimes that's really hard to diagnose. The crankshaft sensor may stop working when it gets hot, okay, and in some cases it may work, it may not. So sometimes you may have really hard time starting the car or not start at all, and if it fails completely, it could happen to the point that your car may not start at all guys. Those are the most common ones. So that sensor, if it's not working correctly, your vehicle will be affected to the point that it will not be drivable and you will need to replace it. We have a special video that explains how to do that. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you next time.